What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. It is your boy, and here we are today. We're going to be watching the Wonder Woman 1984 trailer. Yes! And I'm super excited about this. I was going to actually watch it on the DC Fandom, but because it just dropped, I was at work, and I just saw notifications going off that the new Wonder Woman trailer was out, and I was just like, bro, I need to see it! So here I am, and I'm going to watch it. I'm going to react. I'm going to give you my thoughts about it, all in one little bunch of video. Hopefully you guys enjoy it as much as I'm beyond excited to watch this trailer, yo. This is going to be good, I hope. So three things though that I'm going to be looking for before I just play it right now. I'm going to be looking how the suit looks, the new suit, and what I mean by is like the gold suit looks in action. Two, how Cheetah looks, if we do get a first reveal or first look into Cheetah, how she looks. And three, the plot. What exactly is it going to go into? Is it going to delve into just Cheetah, or are they going to mess around with maybe like the gods or something? Maybe the mythology a little bit more? Who knows? So I'm excited to see it there. I'm excited to see if they take some ideas here from George Perez and implant them here. So I'm excited. All right, without further ado though, I'm just gonna watch the trailer, react. That's what you guys are watching this video for, so I know, I get it, I'm gonna shut up. So let's go.
This world is not yet ready for all that you will do.
More flashback.
And everything will be different.
Yo, she can fly though. Yo, that looks sick though. Oh my gosh, she was swinging from the lightning, bro.
Citizens of the world, I'm here to change your life.
Anything you want.
There's a cheetah, there she is.
Anything you dream of, you can have it.
You think so, guys?
Is he just like a descendant of
you? It's like not one day has passed.
I feel like this is a bait switch. I feel like that motherfucker's not actually.
I wouldn't be like anyone. I want to be an apex predator.
They're playing with us. They play with our heart sway, I'm telling you. She's going to.
Well, now it's my turn. Get used to it.
She done did a switch of bow, bro. Oh, she about to do it.
Never been one for wounds. The answer is always more.
Bro, is she fucking throwing the lasso and flying, bro? That shit was tight.
Never find us.
I forgot to tell you.
What?
Radar.
Will they shoot at us?
The shots. Oh, there she is! Oh!
What did you do?
Yo! Yo!
You know, I'm ready to go.
I think we can do better.
Parachute pants?
Yeah.
Does everybody parachute now?
Alright, bro. I don't know if we need to have like. Whoa! The cheetah! She done showed up! Bro! Oh my gosh, I feel like there's a lot to just digest and sort of take in there. So. Okay, so one of the things for sure, we saw that suit in action a little bit. It looks like some of the CGI for the film is unfinished. Just a tiny bit. The scenes, though, of like her swinging her lasso through the air on some goddess type stuff blew my mind. I absolutely love it. I mean, the shots are looking good. Cheetah looks great. Can I say that? Am I allowed to say that? Cheetah looks okay. She doesn't look bad. I was expecting some dog garbage with Cheetah, but she actually doesn't look terrible. She looks palpable as a character, like, you know what I mean? Like, digestible as an audience member, where the CG sort of like, I'm curious to see more shots of her though, but the fact that they did show her, they were like, even if the CGI is not done, let's just give them Cheetah. They've been waiting for so long. And boy, oh boy, dude, she looks... That scene with Wonder Woman and her, oh, the way they were fighting. Oh, I can't wait to see this in theaters, bro. Hopefully Corona don't last long because I need to see this in theaters. You don't understand, this shit look bomb. So overall, I felt like a really good trailer. First of all, with shock value, with different things. Just overall, a very like stimulating trailer as well. Very entertaining, very bringing you up to speed. It's very interesting because it's also standalone-ish. It's like you don't need to see any other movie. Maybe the first Wonder Woman to understand to get these other things that are coming in, like Chris Pine's character with Steve Trevor, which I think 100% is a bait and switch. I don't think that's actually him. I think she's going to be put under like some sort of like a spell or some shit. Like I don't think it's him. If it is, they're going to have to come up with some crazy reason, but they're holding that close to the fist, and I think that's close to the chest, and I think that's because it's a bait and switch, and I can read it right now. But wow, I mean, wow, very interesting to see this trailer. It definitely does look like it's different from the first Wonder Woman, where it's like, okay, the first Wonder Woman did a good job as to establish this character in the in the film world. Can't even speak after that trailer, in the film world. So it did its job. Now we get to just have fun. And that's what this trailer seems like. It seems like Wonder Woman is just going to kick ass, and I'm here for it, and I'm sure 100% of the people are here for it. And it just looks fun. It looks fun, but also serious at the same time. They're able to sort of juggle the tones there of like having it be that sort of like still that enjoyable movie, but not having it take itself too seriously, but also have it take the ideas seriously and the concepts seriously and these characters seriously, and creating something that the audience will completely enjoy, whether it's newcomers, whether it's comic book readers, whether it's Wonder Woman stands, whatever it may be. This movie looks like it's for everybody, and I absolutely love it, and I absolutely am here for it, and I just cannot wait to watch it. It looks so good. I remember when I first saw the first run of Wonder Woman trailer, I had like this same reaction. I was like blown away, and I was like, whoa, we're gonna see Themyscira. Also, there's flashbacks to Themyscira when Wonder Woman's a kid, flashbacks that we hadn't seen before, so that's gonna be very interesting to see what they add there with Diana being a kid again, and sort of what kind of flashbacks are being brought back for what reason and for what sort of like theme that they're gonna go for, and like, and I'm very curious as to see what it was. It definitely made me feel like I was like rereading them old comic books of Wonder Woman where she was first. Ah, man, it looks good. I am absolutely excited for it. I am highly anticipating this movie, even if Corona somehow doesn't let this movie come out in theaters, because like people are, you know, it's just, this maybe is the way we live today. I really do hope that people go out and support this movie, whether it be like Mulan on a streaming service or whatever. I think this movie definitely does deserve it. I think it's doing something that's groundbreaking by having Wonder Woman there, and like, it's just, it's, I'm excited for it. I don't know what else to say other than I'm excited for it. So you guys let me know, are you guys as excited for Wonder Woman 1984 as I am? Do you guys think this movie's gonna bomb, or do you guys think this movie's gonna do amazing, or do you guys think it's gonna do okay, or do you guys think it's gonna be just what we expect? Let me know down below in the comment section. As always, just like every YouTuber tells you, bro, if you like this video, be sure to leave a like, be sure to subscribe. If you're new to this channel, I don't just do reactions, I open Pokemon cards, I do so many other things on this YouTube channel. I try to keep this YouTube channel kind of like a little corner for you guys to sort of enjoy different content. So yeah, thank you guys for watching until the end. If you did, you guys are the real ones. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. There's so much to recap here with the fandom, so expect a lot of content for DC Comics. I'm sorry, but not sorry, bro.